fuck her.
You did fuck her.
Absolutely did not. I just liked her photo.
When the bells outside, little bitch, you better be ready. When the guys outside.
Oh, I'm about to be so annoying. I'm about to be so annoying with this little microphone. Today, I'm so excited because I'm going to be doing my favorite thing, eating. This is the Dave's Mukbang Extravaganza. Funny story, the last time I went to Dave's, you know how they have the nuggets now? Well, actually, no, you don't know. You probably don't even know because you probably don't even go to Dave's like that, like me, because I'm always at Dave's. Last time I went to Dave's, I got the little nuggets that they just came out with, and I got them extra spicy. I think it's the level before Reaper, which is the maximum amount of spice you can get in your, like, box. So I got these nuggets, right? Tell me why the next morning, I'm shitting blood. Literally, I'm shitting blood. I'm like, oh my God, I need to go to the doctor. I need to call my physician. I need to, like, I don't know, do a DIY colonoscopy. I don't know. I need to do something. And, no, I just got my period. I haven't gotten my period in so long because of Mrs. Birth Control, but I need to get her removed, actually. No, I actually need to get her removed. No, she actually needs to go. Oh, do you guys like my little baby? He's so cute. And he looks hella faded. That's my favorite thing about him. He's like me. Next clip. Hey, guys. So, we made it to the Dave's Hot Chicken. There's so many people inside. I have a little bit of social anxiety, guys, because I'm so beautiful. I just know if I go in there, they're going to start staring at me. And now, a word from our sponsor, BetterHelp. Imagine. Come with me inside. Don't actually come with me, though, if I find out y'all are edging to my videos. Okay, just kidding.
I forget how elegantly she feels her. Oh, never mind. Oh, so many choices. Oh, she went for the spy. Oh.
Oh my God, I have to. I didn't even have it on. So the employee told us that you're not allowed to give people extra hot nuggets. So I shot my guts out for nothing. Like, what do you mean? He and I were literally talking about this. The guy who served us last time, I could tell he does not wipe after he shits. Like, I put it on God. I put it on your soul. Okay. Don't fucking tell me I don't have storage because I deleted my phone, half of it. Time to grub, you guys. We got the goods. I have a 10-piece nugget. She has her platter. I didn't mean to make it sound like that. Ooh, they look extra crispy. I still can't believe they literally served me an illegal serving of Dave's Hot Chicken, extra hot chicken bites. Why the fuck would you do that? You wanted me to die. You gotta watch your backs, ladies. You know, before, it was popular to kidnap women. Then it was popular. I'm not gonna say that. Then, now, it's popular to try and do attempted homicide via chicken nug. Stay woke. It's like that one guy said. Y'all ever notice that
the more and more people come up missing, the more they release more chicken sandwiches and shit.
They're kidnapping women. And they're baking us into Dave's Hot Chicken and boneless meal deals.
I can't stand you after showing me Fresh.
Okay. It's such a good movie.
You guys need to watch Fresh.
It's an excellent movie. I love that movie. So much. It's so good. I had a dream with Sebastian Stan in it a couple of times, actually. I had a fresh dream, actually. It just reminded me.
What was it about? What happened? We're back in action. A new piece of Pete Davidson lore just dropped. I saw this on the internet.
I'm hearing about this right now.
This is alleged. But allegedly, well, I think he admitted this himself, so it's like less alleged, more through the grapevine. But, you know, he just came out of rehab. I guess he was in rehab for the past year. Rehab? Yeah, that's why he wasn't being annoying. I love Pete Davidson, by the way, so this is with love. I have a shirt with his face on if you don't believe me. Insert clip. No, yeah, so he had come out of rehab, God bless him, and he was telling his stories, you know, his little, like, drug stories when he was doing scandalous shit. And apparently, when he went to Aretha Franklin's funeral,
oh my God, it's gonna be so bad.
He was high. Not weed high. Ketamine high. Horse tranquilizer.
Oh my God.
High. And he went up to the family when it was time to go up and, you know, to wish them well. Keep in mind, his date was Ariana Grande. He went with Ariana.
His date to the funeral.
Keep in mind, his date to the funeral, mind you. And he goes up to the family and he says, "Hey, just wanted to pay my R-E-S-P-E-C-T-S. Pete! Pete! What's wrong with you? What's wrong with you?
I don't know. I feel like I would have laughed a little bit.
The crazy shit is I see where he was coming from. He's like, it was a terrible joke. I should never said it. I'm like,
it's a good joke. It's a great joke, even.
I'm gonna need you to stop.
Okay, he's creative for that, but I hope Pete Davidson comes to my funeral.
Me too.
I want him there.
I'd appreciate that. Mm-hmm. I'd be like, open casket, please. Mm-hmm. Bottom portion. I wonder if Ariana's ever done hard drugs. Like, it's genuine curiosity. She doesn't have to tell me. She doesn't have to tell anybody. I don't care for her to come out about it. But I'm always going to wonder. Because those boyfriends get you. Mm-hmm. They're like, babe, come on. The sex feels amazing.
You cannot pay me to have sex on ketamine. I have someone who was on ketamine for medical reasons. I don't even understand how Pete was standing at that wedding. Because when I was on that shit, I could not see nothing, bro. I was dizzy as fuck. Ketamine would have me messed up. And to have sex on it is crazy. You gotta be insane. You cannot pay me. Oh my God. This reminds me of, That one country mukbanger who sits in her car and just eats.
Wendy eats? Yeah. Oh my God, you guys remember Wendy eats? Oh my God, I forgot about her. That was the OG mukbanger. And when she bite it, she'll be like, I need to do that right now. All right, let's talk about it. Dave, you need to give it up.
That's weird. This looks like a cat.
Look at this shit. It does. It does look like a cat stepped in it. Dave, you need to give it up with these flimsy ass, well, low-key stiff. How is it stiff and flimsy at the same time? Just give it up. I'm not going to eat this. The only way I'm going to eat this is if I'm starving and it's 2 in the morning and it's the last thing in my to-go box.
The jig is up, Dave.
It's up.
Done.
Guys, you know, everybody has their New Year's resolutions. I've been half-assing mine, I'm not gonna lie. Everybody, let's stop pretending that you guys are immediately doing all your resolutions. Because I know you already broke at least 2. Because I did, for sure.
Yeah?
Yeah. The not one. For sure. That one. I stay breaking. I just stopped saying that shit. Big Mama always goes back to her little bear cubs. And technically, they're not talking to men, okay? But I think I'm going to, like, rephrase that one. It's less talking to them and more hooking up with them. I'm not doing casual hookups anymore. But if I need to talk to you for a little bit of validation, I'm probably going to do it. But I have been leaving guys on delivery like crazy because, man, they are. Something about the new year, they're like, let me text you. Fuck off. You ain't really fuck with me way back then, but how about that? Because I'm up right now. Yeah, I don't know the rest.
I bet wishes he was here.
He does. He's been texting me, hitting me up to scoop me. So I didn't pick up. And then like 4 hours later, I texted him. I was like, you called me? Yeah, women are not innocent, y'all. Sometimes I wonder, like, people who I stopped talking to, are they going to watch my YouTube videos? Break no contact and text me right now if you are. This is the only time you're allowed to break no contact.
Pussy, man. A nigga like me, man. I love the game. I love the hustle, man.
Not even. Just drop a star emoji.
Drop an emoji. Drop a bow. Drop a pink bow. That's how I'm going to know. Because I really do be wondering that. Because, like, I would do that. I don't have anybody who makes YouTube videos, but if there was somebody, I would stalk them. Even if I broke it off, I'm still going to stalk you.
That's wrong.
One thing about me, I'm going to always use my resources. The internet is a resource. And if your page is on public, you can't stop me. It's like you're begging for it.
I hate when people say that, like, going on somebody's Instagram all the time is stalking. Why are they a public account then if you do not want to be seen?
That's what I'm saying. Like, also, the whole stalking conversation is like, relax, bro, relax. I'm not going to do nothing. Mm-hmm. I'm not Joe Goldberg. Like, why are you tripping because I'm looking at my ex's page?
No, for real, it's a crime to look at some pictures.
Mm-hmm. One thing about me, I'ma always stalk you. Yeah, at the end of the day, I always am. If that page is on public, I'm clicking on it. If you uploaded a new video, I am updated.
If you're tagged in anything, I've seen it.
If you liked anything, I've already bookmarked it. But yeah, no, I'm always keeping track of you, Pookie Bears. I love you forever. Even if I ghosted you. You know, a lot of people try to tell you, I'm not the problem. I am the problem. And I know that. And I own up to it.
Maybe everybody's the problem.
I think everybody is the problem. No, I think everybody is the problem. And then I wasn't the problem. And then they made me the problem. So I became the problem. Simple as that. Hallie and DDG, bro. Hallie, it's not too late. It's not too late.
She's like, girl, you have a whole baby. Because no, who else was saying womp-womp before me?
Nobody. Like, she's always saying cartoon noises, too. So it's like...
She's always just talking.
You know? she's always just running that fucking mouth, running that fucking mouth.
It's true. It's true.
A 10-year-old with Down syndrome. Womp womp. Did you just say womp womp to a 10-year-old with Down syndrome?
I mean, look, I read today about a 10-year-old girl with Down syndrome who was taken from her mother and put in a cage.
Wah,
I read about a did you say womp womp to a 10-year-old with Down syndrome
what
being
I
taken
said
from
is
her
you
mother?
Can pick anything
How
you
dare
want
you?
Up, but the bottom line
How
is very
dare
clear.
You?
When you cross
How absolutely
the border
dare you,
illegally,
sir?
You
How
have
dare
given
you?
A-
Because why did he say that? Bro, Republicans will do anything to win an argument. Homeless starving children in Africa. Womp womp. The economy. Stocks.
Womp womp. Oh my god. You know what else I popularized?
What?
Don't piss me off. Don't piss me off. Yeah. Don't piss me off.
Don't. Zone. I've been saying that.
Now all of a sudden, everybody don't want to be pissed off. That was me.
I can confirm. That was my best friend first. I'll literally be like, "You're pissing me off. Don't piss me off right now."
Girls, why would you piss me off? Like, don't piss me off.
2024. I have one rule: don't piss me off. It's that simple. So if you got cut and you didn't make it with me to 2024, it's probably because you pissed me off.
You can have the first bite.
Okay.
Guys, be honest. If I don't blow up as a YouTuber, will you guys subscribe to my OnlyFans, please?
I'll do it.
Thanks.
Take one for the team.
She said you ain't got it like that, bitch. Oh my god. That hurt me real bad. Disclaimer, I would never make an OnlyFans. So if you see someone and they're saying it's an OnlyFans of me, it's AI. It's AI computer generated images. Bro, I feel like that is gonna be a thing. But as AI transforms and progresses, people are gonna start having like porn pages of themselves that are not even real, like, because deep fakes are already a thing. I don't even want to imagine what deep fakes are already doing for people online. Like, what if I was just searching myself up on like the dark web, or well,
very scary.
Well, Reddit. I mean Reddit, not the dark web.
Reddit is the dark web.
And then there's just like a fake ass picture of me with my face is like edited on or some shit. With my ass and titties, quote unquote my ass and titties out. I'd be like, damn, she look better than what I actually look like. Fuck.
Bring me up a cup size. Give me a BBL.
A little lipo here, a little lipo there. Shave down the chin as well, if you can.
I have the urge to eat this receipt like a little billy goat.
Do it. Best friend eats receipt in Dave's parking lot. The immediate thumbnail, like... Y'all, we are connected in the mind, like, y'all don't understand the amount of friendship it takes to do something that uncoordinated and coordinated. Mr. Beast's thumbnails are funny. Go look at his thumbnails if you want to laugh.
Oh, I'm making my friends survive in a Walmart with nothing but a granola bar and Gatorade. And then his thumbnail is him all beating, you know?
It's him, like, in the corner of the Walmart, like...
Mr. Beast is like Diet David Dobrik.
Yeah.
Without charity. Or with charity, I guess.
With charity. They both do charity. David Dobrik, giving away Teslas is not fucking charity, you asshole.
Why would anybody want a Tesla? Give me money.
Give me fucking money, especially if, like, I'm broke already and you want to give me a fucking Tesla? Keep it. It is yours. Because how am I going to be able to even afford, if I break apart, that I'm dead. It's over. If I crash that shit, I'm over. My insurance rate up. So, no. Unless all of those are just rumors and I'm just completely uneducated. I don't care!
You know what he was doing? He was probably like passing around the same Tesla, but he was getting it wrapped.
Oh, yes! I don't doubt that David had a lot of paid actors before.
His whole friend group was paid actors.
Paid actors.
You don't even talk to those niggas no more.
He really doesn't. David Dobrik's really a terrible person.
Girl, freaking Jason Nash on TikTok Live begging for money. Have you seen that?
Like, oh, give me a cowboy hat, guys. We need a cowboy hat. Okay, it's in a star.
Everyone, yeah. Talking about pegging like 2020.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh my gosh, I want
to
peg my boyfriend.
I remember my situationship at the time. I used to like beg him to let me peg him as a joke, but like not a joke, but like as a joke. It pissed him off so fucking bad. I'm pretty sure it's like 50% of the reason he's like stopped liking me. It was just because I asked to fuck his ass so much.
All this girl talks about
is begging. Oh, she just wants to use me for my body. God. It's like, yeah, that tight little hole looks appetizing. I want to know what it's like to have a penis.
I'm gonna slap it.
Yes, actually, it's very fun. But they're very like wobbly.
What did I go say?
I realized I tend to fuck men who I like want to be. Like, you know, Lil Nas X, he was like, I want to fuck the ones I envy. That's how I feel. When I get a boyfriend, I'm going to wrap a roll up around that shit.
Oh my God, I'm going to scoop out a chamoy pickle.
Oh my God!
Put it on.
Yes, put a chamoy pickle kit on his dick, ladies. How to get him attached quick.
We need to try one of those for a mukbang.
My next mukbang is going to be the chamoy pickle kit.
That should probably taste like death.
It probably tastes terrible.
Two,
I don't believe three. that should taste, especially the ones where they put the Takis, the Cheetos, and then they wrap it in like the spaghetti, chamoy spaghetti.
Whoa, that's good as fuck. Yeah, oh my God.
Red sprinkle sugar sauce candy.
Cut the cameras. Oh my God, that's really good.
Roll up.
Too many textures happening at once.
Yeah, no, and flavors, because it's also sweet, sour, savory, and like pickled. So what actually is going on?
It's really a crazy concept when you think about it. Somebody was like, let me put chamoy in this pickle.
Yeah, not even, because you have to like soak it to get it red. Somebody It started with those candies, the gushers that they would put chamoy and tajin on. Whoever did that for the first time, I remember you in 2016. That shit blew the fuck up, just like these chamoy pickle kits. You started this. The butterfly effect, the domino effect. One tiny...
created this, the chamoy pickle kit.
This is your fault. He's patient zero for this bullshit. We gotta find his ass.
That's awesome.
Damn, I forgot!